Good evening, everyone. My name is Robin Devine, and I'm a massage therapist here in the city of Calgary, and I'm also a certified lymphedema therapist. So if you've known Rick for any period of time, or if you've seen any of the things that we've been speaking about on Facebook, or any of the emails that you would have gotten from Rick, you would have learned about a little bit about lymphedema. And so, unfortunately, not a lot of people know about lymphedema, so I'm very blessed that one of my dear clients has taken such an interest in kind of sharing this information with the general public. It sounds like a lot of the times I'm just sort of screaming at the top of my lungs and trying to get doctors and surgeons and the general public to understand what the intensity and the severity is of lymphedema. So just a quick little understanding so you know what we're talking about is the lymphatic system is a part of your body that is your immune system. And its goal is to help clean and detoxify and build up strength so you can fight off everyday infections and so forth. With lymphedema, something's happened to that lymphatic system and it's damaged. And it could be from birth or it could be from trauma. The most common that everybody hears about is with surgery, with people with breast cancer or with any kind of cancer where they've removed lymph nodes. And basically that lymphatic system kind of shuts down. And unfortunately what happens is we get huge enlargements of limbs. And so just even the awareness that you have from this evening is you'll probably be at the store or at the mall or maybe going on an airplane and you'll see individuals that have one large limb or two limbs or individuals that have garments or long sleeves that are very tight compression on those limbs. And generally what you're seeing is lymphedema. We're gaining a little bit more awareness. Kathy Bates is one of our major spokespeople down in the United States, and there's becoming more and more awareness. But even with those international awareness days that happen every single day of the year, there's just not enough knowledge about it. And the unfortunate part is that it's a lifelong condition. So when you see Rick and when you see people who have lymphedema, what you have to realize is they have to deal with this for the rest of their lives every single day. So not only is it a grueling, taxing condition that leaves your limbs extremely heavy and hard to move, it makes the quality of your life very, very different, and it also becomes a very expensive condition. I currently see Rick on a weekly basis, and I have an apprentice who also goes once a week. And so not only the therapy, but all the garments and all the equipment that is required gets very, very expensive. And currently we're on the shopping list for an electric wheelchair for Mr. Rick. So it just adds up, and it's a lifelong affliction, so it definitely doesn't get any easier. And the more support and the more awareness that we can create, especially within the city, would be phenomenal. So I very much, from my heart, am so touched that you came up this evening to support Rick. It's our second benefit concert, and every single dollar that we are able to raise today goes towards his ability to continue dealing with lymphedema every single day. So I truly, truly appreciate that you came up today. So.
Welcome, Mr. God. I'll be here in a minute. Sure.
Big hand for Chantel. Hi.
Hello, Rick.
Thank you for being here. I really appreciate it. Otherwise, I'd be sitting at home watching Netflix. As I put myself together.
Oh, did I hurt that?
Chantel says we go back a long way. 30 some odd years ago, I know she hates me saying that, but we had been performing together. We went to New Brunswick, performed at Festival by the Sea, and just she's always been a great friend. For some of you that saw my show before, A little bit of it is the same, but most of it isn't. Tonight, we're going on the basis that Night Moves magazine once referred to me, which is in Vancouver, referred to me as a cross between Gordon Lightfoot, Louis Armstrong, and Friar Tuck. You can't pay anybody to write that. So we're going to do a little of the stylings of all three of those things that gave me that name. Is my hat casting a terrible shadow on my face?
Yep.
How's it now?
Still my hat.
Ooh, yeah, well, I... Well, I have... I have that old well, lymphedema. Yes, some. Well, yeah, now sometimes. Yeah, well, sometimes it makes me wanna scream. Well, I am in lots of pain, but it won't beat me as long as I have friends like Robin and Chelsea who are not afraid to treat me. Yes, I have that old lymphedema, which kind of brings me to this segue. Somewhere over the rainbow, way up high, the dreams that you dream of, wanting a lullaby. Oh yeah, well somewhere over the rainbow, our skies are blue, and the dreams that you dare to dream of, they really do come true. Someday I wish upon a star, wake up where the clouds are far behind me. Oh yeah, where sunshine melts like lemon drops way above the chimney tops. That's where you find me. I said somewhere over rainbow, yeah, bluebirds fly. They fly over rainbow. Why can't I? This is called scat. I wondered how that actually got the name. I think it was because, you know, blues players really like to drink. So they get a little confused and forget the words and go, and then some guy sitting at the table, and one guy says, "What's he doing?" Some other guy'd say, "Ah, he's just scattered brained." And he said, "I think you said it's scat." That's where it comes from. Well, somewhere over the rainbow, way up high, yeah, there's a land that I dream of, wanting a lullaby. Boom, 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 boom. you clap. Not trying to teach you how to be an audience, but it's your first time. I'm not going to let this beat me. You know I love you too, Sean. 20 more pounds, you'd look just like me, man.
15.
15, okay. I'm not going to let it beat me. This cannot take my life away. It cannot take away the things that make me happy. Music makes me happy. Working at the Seed makes me happy. Doing God's work makes me happy. And I'm not here to preach to anybody, but I'm not going to be sorry for who I am, and I will mention it a few times today.
Amen.
Amen. If you have a problem with it, see her. We are videotaping this tonight. We were going to try and live stream this, but I couldn't figure out how to do that. Because I'm old. And you know how it is. Kids, you know, that's, you've seen the joke with the little baby boy standing there on the phone going, no, grandma, the mouse. No, it's not a live mouse. It's a little, no, grandma, click it, left click it. No, grandma. It's the same for grandfathers. I want to do this song for you because I know that Chantel did a song I wrote called Northland. I wrote this song a number of years ago as well called Northern Lights. I just love the Northern Lights. In my bucket list, I have a new bucket list. I mean, essentially 12 years ago or so, I kind of died in the hospital. And my beautiful mother, who is here, by the way. Everybody say hi, Mom.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Mom.
Say hi back, Mom.
Hi.
I won't embarrass her. But my bucket list is changed. First thing that changed on it is now I'd just like to live longer the second time. But the other things is, like, because of this lymphedema, one of the things that I really want to do, it's on my bucket list, is I want to dance again. Yeah. Okay, I want to dance. Get up there and just boogie. I want to curl again. And most of you are going, well, that's not anything to attain to. But curling is great. And I want to curl again. And one of the other things is I want to live again where the Northern Lights are out every night. Now, the thing about the Northern Lights that a lot of people don't realize is they are always there. Mm-hmm. You just can't always see them. But they are always there. And they are amazing. This song is called Northern Lights, and I wrote it for a major media festival that I was one of the two performers for in Los Angeles. At the Beverly Hilton, in the same room where they do the... It's not the Oscars, but it's the one before that. What do they call it?
Emmys.
No, not the Emmys. It's the...
Golden Globes.
Golden Globes, thank you very much. Same theater as the Golden Globes. And there I was. And the Northwest Territories government paid me to record this song and put it on a CD, and we gave it out to every media representative in the USA. So I figured when I got up there, everybody'd be singing it. No. But I was. If you feel like dancing, you can. $5, that's all it'll cost you. Northern Lights, those bright Northern Lights, softest shades of green my eyes have ever seen. Northern Lights, fiery skies, you light up my eyes. As you streak across the sky, my heart begins to sigh. Our Northern Lights, so set the Northern sky up. I could see your heavenly smile. And as you show me every dance you know, forever I will cast my eye to you, Northern Lights. Yes, Northern Lights. Like diamonds in the sky, my heart begins to sigh. Northern Lights. Forever I will cast my eye, Northern Lights. Yes, sweet Northern Lights. Diamonds in the sky, my heart begins to sigh. Northern Lights, sweet Northern Lights. Yeah, Northern Lights. Another line. Talking about changing horses in midstream. I do like the blues. Does anybody here like the blues?
Yeah.
Good. This is my kind of blues. You gotta start off with a bass player. Because you start off with the simplest part first. I'm not saying that bass players are simple. You take it any way you want. But there's a reason we only give them four strings. I shouldn't have said that. Some of my best friends used to be bass players. Yeah, when I get the blues, I get me a rocking chair. I say when I get the blues, I get me a rocking chair. Blues overtake me, I ride my way out of here. Telephone booth. You give me one more kiss. Last me a long, long time. One more kiss to last me a long, long time. Kiss my baby till the feeling is a head like wine. But it's a flip flop fly. Don't care if I. Don't care if I die. Yeah, well, don't ever leave me. Don't ever
say goodbye.
Very good. Now I'm going to try the little of the scat thing here. So what I'm going to do is I'll scat to you and then you scat back. You got it? It's easier than you think, trust me. sing. We got a room full of Ukrainians. Gonna have to retrain you. Here we go again. One more time, just let me finish the good. Diddly beep bop. Here comes the best one. Now we're gonna, you're all warmed up. Because you screwed up. Cutie booty. Cutie doo doo doo. Dee 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 dee. Boop a doop a doop a doop. Here you flip, flop, fly. Don't care if I die. Flip, flop, fly. Don't care if I die. Said now, don't ever leave me, and you don't ever leave me. Don't ever say goodbye. I said, don't ever say that. Goodbye. Thank you. That was kind of fun, wasn't it? Yes, the last thing we'll do is going to be good tonight. Now, y'all wonder, because Robin, is the reverb on when I'm talking?
Maybe.
Can you do me a favor? One of my oldest and dearest friends in the world, and I mean both ways, Howard Mackay, on sound here. You'll see him playing around with me every once in a while. He's an amazing musician, but please give him a big hand. He's my friend. He's been my friend for almost 35 somewhat years, right?
Yeah.
Whatever. To show you, he was born and raised in Yellowknife, and I moved, so he moved. Love it. Robin was saying, you never know what's going to cause lymphedema. I mean, I was fine. I mean, a big guy, but I was fine. Everything was wonderful. Everything was great. I could buy my clothes off the rack, and then one day in a freak twerking accident. Where the hell did that come from? I'm sorry if you actually saw me doing that. It was oh my goodness. One day, though, and literally 2 years ago at a Stampede breakfast that I was performing at, I was in the sun and I got a blister on my leg right here. And I thought it was a sunburn blister or something, but it just wouldn't heal. But nobody could tell me what it was. Not a soul out there could tell me what it was. Not a doctor anywhere had any idea. And some doctor decided it was a foot and wound thing, and he decided he was going to start bandaging me up and giving me compression, but he didn't treat the wound. And it got worse. And eventually, within 6 months, both of my legs disintegrated. The skin was gone. I could barely walk. there was stuff pouring out of my legs, like you wouldn't, it was literally, I would put my pants on, and before I could get to the door to put my shoes on, my pants were soaking wet. Just from everything pouring out of it. But nobody would say, yes, you've got lymphedema. They didn't know. I get into the hospital for 2 months. They cured the wounds. They got me to dry up. And it's a daily battle as to whether it's dry or it's not dry. I've gotten bigger. And no, I don't eat a lot of pizza. But I've gotten bigger. But I have people out there who look after me because they know what I've got. But you'd be surprised how many doctors would look at me and say, I don't know what that is. My own doctor said to me, I don't know what it is, but I'll find out. So she studied it and found out what it was, but she still said, your therapists know best. So what I'm trying to say is, we've got a disease here where there's a lot of people that have it. And according to according to the facts that I've heard, I can't say that word. I can't say that or Saskatchewan. I can't say that either. The facts are this. There are more people suffering with lymphedema in North America than there are with AIDS, ALS, MS, MD, and Parkinson's combined. And all the other ones have research, funding, groups that jump out, and doctors who can take care of it.
That's right.
But they can't with lymphedema. And I work in an environment where there's a lot of sickness. There's a lot of bugs, and there's a lot of people who just get sick because it's just the nature of the business. I work with the homeless, and I love my job. I love the people I work with. I love the people I serve. It's the greatest job on earth to help others. I don't have an immune system, and yet I don't get sick. Mm-hmm. I thank God for that, by the way.
Amen.
But please, please, find out about this and help those around you. Since I've figured out what I've got, I have met so many people that suffer from the same ailment, from the same disease, that I didn't know were out there before. And some of them you'd never be able to tell, and then there's others like me. Be aware of it. That's all I ask. That's my sermon. Do we have a collection plate? There's an old song that I love to do. I love to do old tunes, la 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 la, with a little bit of a blues flavor to it. Robin said, I do good cover tunes. I don't know if you like the cover tunes or originals, but we're going to do a mix of both. But I love this song, man. I just love this song. It always made me feel so good. Thank you. Scut down the alley looking for a fight. Down at the moon on a hot summer's night, yeah. Singing the blues while the lady cats cry. Hey, hey, stray cat, you're a swell guy. Wish I could be so carefree wild. I got cat class and I got cat style. Here's where you put your singing skills to your use. Ready? Are you ready?
Yep.
How about the other 40 of you? Are hit the road, Jack. Don't you come back no more, no more. Hit the road, Jack. Don't you come back no more. Ready? Hear what I say? Hit the road, Jack. Don't you come back no more, no more, no more. Hit the road, Jack. Don't you come back no more. Woman, oh woman, don't you treat me so mean. You're the sweetest thing that I've ever seen. I turn around and go. Just say no, whoa, 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 hit the road, Jack. Don't you come back no more, no more, no more, no more. Hit the road, Jack, don't you come back. Very good, don't you come back. Don't you come back no more. No mother chasing my surround. Shut down the alley and looking for a fight. Moon on a hot summer's night, yeah. Singing the blues while the baby cats cry. Hey, hey, stray cat, a real swell guy. I wish I could be so carefree wild. I got cat class and I got cat style. Ooh, 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 sing. Good. Anybody here like music from the 50s?
Yes.
Anybody here actually around when there was some? I get criticized because I do music that a lot of people sit there and go, oh, that's really good, I never heard it before. To that I say, here's a song I wrote this morning. I got to bring these words out because I haven't actually done this in a while, but I love this song. Just
yes.
You notice that old 50s beat?
Yeah. Yeah.
Every night I hope and pray a dream a lover will come my way, a girl to hold in my arms and know the magic of a chance, because I want a girl to call my own. I want a dream lover, cause I don't have to dream alone. A dream lover, where are you? With a love that's oh so true, and a hand that I can hold. Yeah, I grow old because I want a girl to call my own. I want a dream lover, I don't have to dream alone. Someday, I don't know how, I hope you hear my plea. Someway, I don't know how, she'll bring her love to until then, I'll go to sleep and dream again. That's the only thing to do until my lover's dreams come true. And then I want a girl to call my own. I want a dream lover, so I don't have to dream. I want a dream lover, so I don't have to dream. You know a dream lover, so I don't have to dream. Hello. Oh yeah. fun song?
Yes.
Just fun. You know, there's another fun song I like too. Just there was a group called was it Three Dog Night? Who the heck was it? Hey? Well, I know there was a group called Three Dog Night, but it's, everybody's going, "Oh yeah, that was a good song." Well, here's one the Three Dog Night might have done. I'm gonna get me snapped. Okay. But I just want to put a little bit of my own lilt to it because it's not quite apropos for the way we are today. But I can't remember if it was Three Dog Night. Was it Three Dog Night? No. Who? Stop it.
What's that?
What's the name of the song?
Get out my back door.
Creedence Clearwater
Revival. Okay? I just got home from Illinois. Locked the front door. Oh boy. Got to sit down. Take a rest on the porch. Imagination said sin. Heard a soon I'm singing. Doo doo doo. Singing out my back door. A giant dude called Wheels. Statue wearing high heels. Look at all those happy creatures dancing on the lawn. A dinosaur Victrola. Mr. Jukebox Owens. Doo doo doo. Looking out my back door. And Marines and elephants. They're playing in the band. Won't you take a ride? On the flying spoon, do do do, wondrous apparitions, and vice magicians, do do do, looking out my back door. Take a ride on the flying spoon. The apparitions is provided by magicians. Do, 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 looking out my back door. Do, 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 looking out my back door.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, yeah.
faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof, her beauty in the moonlight overthrew you. She tied you to the kitchen chair, broke your throne and cut your hair, and from your lips she drew the hallelujah.
Everybody.
Before I've seen this room, I've walked this floor. I used to live alone before I knew you, and I've seen your flag on the marble arch. Love is not a victory march, it's cold and it's a broken hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 sing it now, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. One of the best friends I've made in this city, Nathan Johnson, folks. '85, in St. John, New Brunswick, the first year that they had the Festival by the Sea, all the people from the Northwest Territories and the Yukon were kind of pitted together, and we were taken out by bus 40 miles from St. John. And we were taken to this farm, this beautiful cattle farm. I don't know if any of you have ever been to the East Coast, but the farms out there are beautiful, man. They're painted, their lawns are cut. It just looks like it's a picture postcard. It really is. And they had set up a stage for us. We didn't know we were there to perform, but we enjoyed it. They set up a stage for us. And at the end of the show, they asked if I would come up and do one more song. And I didn't really know what to do. But I came up and I started to reach for my guitar and I looked. I was up against a barn. And I swear I could see for like 20 miles in these rolling valleys and hills that were just all just rolling together. They were green and it was July. And so there was this beautiful set of colors coming through everything. It was just breathtaking. And I said out loud, I'm not sure what to sing, but as I said that, I can actually hear my voice echoing off of these valleys and hills, and it was the most amazing thing. I'm going to need a little reverb on this here, Howard, to get that same ambience back. As a matter of fact, turn it up now. Because as I spoke, I could hear that. And it just blew me away. And I, 1 second here. I just started to sing without the guitar. To the point where I had everybody crying. There must have been about 200 people there with us. It was wonderful to have this kind of private concert in that kind of setting. By the way, the sun was just going down, but it was going down behind me. So I was getting this shadow. And it felt very, very godlike, I'll tell you that. It was so amazing. When I just started to sing, "Oh, Danny boy, the pipes are calling from glen to glen and down the mountainside. The summer's gone and all the flowers are dying. Tis you must go and I must bide." I don't know if you know this song, why it was written, but the explanation I learned years ago was in Ireland, when the British had taken it over, they made it against the law for anyone to write songs or sing songs about the Irish or about Ireland. They wanted no patriotism whatsoever. So somebody came up with this song, and Danny Boy was Ireland. And it was their patriotism. "But come ye back when summer's in the meadow, or when the valley's hushed and white with snow. 'Tis Abbey here in sunshine or in shadow. Danny boy, oh Danny boy, I love you so. But if it's fall and all the flowers are dying and you are dead, as dead you will may be, I'll come and find the spot where you are lying. Kneel and say an ave there for thee. But come ye back when summer's in the meadow, when the valley's hushed and white with snow. For I'll be here in sunshine or in shadows. Oh, Danny boy, oh, Danny boy, I love you so." to get to do stuff weird like that every once in a while. I try. It's just fun. I have to take off my... You like my glove? Got it at a half-off sale. I forgot the other one at home, so it's actually like a three-quarter sale. I love this old guitar. Oh, I love it. Somebody stepped on my other guitar and broke the neck. Well, not today. And this guitar taught me to do a lot of weird things. For instance, you know that you can find in music all over, you can find really, really wild stuff. For instance, one of our favorite songs is "Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me." Doing that bluesy thing again. I once was lost, now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. But did you know? It also fits. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound. Saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Blind, but now I see. But my favorite is this. This was a song that was kind of big when I was a kid, but there was a lot of, it came from a long time ago. And a group called Eric Bird and the Animals made it real famous. House of the Rising Sun, do you remember it?
Yeah.
It had that nice little, when I was just learning how to play guitar, my folks bought me a guitar. And I want to just tell you how guitars have gone. I think it was about $24 they paid for that old harmony guitar. And today, if I'd had that same guitar today on this stage, that exact same guitar, it's well worth over $80,000. $20,000, $25,000. Not that money meant anything. But I didn't know how to tune the guitar. Somebody said, well, you tune every fifth string. So I tuned all five strings. So I learned all my chords funny. And then somebody showed me you didn't do that. So then I had to retune it and learn it again, and this is what I got. But I'm going to just play this for you, because there is a group out of the southern states called the Blind Boys of Alabama. We heard of them? Amazing. Four. Now there's four of them. They used to be five old blind guys who had spotters. Because while they were singing, they just had this hankering to get up and start walking. They would. Thing is, they could be walking off the end of the stage or to the side. They didn't know where they were. And the spotters had to steer them to bring them back, but they did this. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, now I'm found. Was blind, now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear. Grace my fears relieved. saved a wretch like me. I was what flowed. Noticed that a friend of mine came in. I have to point him out, because while I've been sitting here watching, I could see the name Cardell, but Sammy just came in and sat down and he blocked out the sign. Because what are you, Sammy, 9'3" and 900 pounds? What are you? He's just the biggest man I ever met in my life. I love him.
Yeah, okay. Gospel music has its way. Do you want to try a little gospel with me?
Yes.
I want to sing back on this gospel tune because it's just fun. Gospel actually technically didn't start until about 1955. And it started with a song called This Little Light of Mine, I'm Gonna Let It Shine. Because technically gospel in its purest form is... first line sung, second line, third line sung, fourth line is same as second line. And it repeated that way. And that's what a true gospel song was. And the first one that they could find was 1955. This song that I'm going to do with you guys, you're going to be singing it with me, was written long before that, but they didn't sing it that way until about 1967 or 68, somewhere in there. Seems to me I remember it so. Actually, what we should do is everybody stand up. Except my mom. And I want you to sway to the music. They follow me. Ready? Here we go. That's it. Now clap your hands in time to the music. Good. As soon as you figure it out, join in. Are you ready now? Here we go. Oh, happy day. That's it.
To rejoice, yeah, to rejoice.
I take every opportunity here. Yes, as a matter of fact, at some shows they used to make people stand four or five times so I could say, yeah, I get four outstanding ovations. Why did you turn my guitar off? There it is. You didn't, it unplugged. Sorry, my fault. Don't even touch nothing. A lot of people make something like this happen. First of all, one more time, a big hand for Robin and Chelsea for just being there for me. They see me at my weakest, and they still love me.
That's the way it is.
Thank you so much. And that is the way it is. Yeah. I thank God every day for that. I got to tell this story. Howard used to, whenever I produce big shows up in the territories, Howard used to be my stage manager. And I was having a real hard time. First of all, I wasn't really sure that I wanted to do this particular show. It was the Miss Yellowknife pageant, but it had been there for years, and so I decided to put it on. We got rid of a lot of the stuff that you don't want to see in a pageant. And we tried to go with strong stuff that was good, but they were just taking it as a big joke. And I got mad at them one day, all of them. And I had them all line up, and I brought Howard in, and I said, this is Howard. You can call him Howard. You can call him Mr. Howard. You can call him Sir. You can call him Mr. McKay. Mr. McKay, sorry. Sorry, Howard. You can call him Mr. McKay. You can call him whatever. You can call him God, but you do whatever he says. And that's it. I walked away. So 2 weeks later, we were having dress rehearsal. And Howard says to one of the women as she was coming down the stairs to get ready, where is so-and-so? She should have been down here two numbers ago. And the girl runs up the stairs and she's yelling this girl's name out and going, yeah, that... The guy, God said, get downstairs now. And I thought, well, they learned. I wonder if I can do this without the pick. Let's try this. Probably not. Get used to these things. I was a children's performer for about, I don't know, 15 years. And I used to go to parties and I used to play this song because the kids loved it. It was kind of fun. Why not? And the mayor of Vancouver, his niece was having her fourth birthday party. And he said, and you have to play a special song for her. And I went, okay. And I figured that would be it. So I went there ready to play this song. When I got there and I said, hey, what song would you like for your special song? And she went, Desperado. What? I want Desperado. She was 4 years old. I said, okay, can you sing it with me? She goes, Desperado, why don't you come to your senses? And then, all right. And she sang the whole song. And I thought, that's pretty good. And then I said, but I got a better one. Yeah. In 1986, I saw Kenny Loggins do this live. 86 was a good year. I also saw Bob Dylan wearing spandex. Pretty sad, actually. Christopher Robin and I walked alone. The branches lit up by the moon, posing our questions to owl and eagle as the days slipped away all too soon. I wandered much further today than I should. I
I can't seem to find my way back to the woods, so help me if you can. Got to get back to the house, the corner by one. You'd be surprised, there's so much to be done. Count all the bees in the hive, chase all the clouds from the sky. Back to the days of Christopher Robin and Pooh. Winnie the Pooh doesn't know what to do. He's got a honey jar stuck on his nose. Came to me asking my help and advice. From there no one knows where he goes. So I sent him to ask Ollie Owl if he's there, how to loosen the jar from the nose of a bear. And help me if you can, I've got to get back to the house, the corner by one. Will you be surprised, there's so much to be done. Count all the bees in the hive, chase all the clouds from the sky. Back to the days of Christopher Robin. It's hard to explain how a few precious things seem to follow throughout all our lives. After all said and done, I was watching my son sleeping there, my bear by his side. So I tucked him in, kissed him, and as I was going, I swear that old bear whispered, "Boy, welcome home. Help me if you can, I've got to get back to the house, the Pooh corner by one. You'd be surprised, there's so much to be done. You count all the bees in the hive, chase all the clouds from the sky. Back to the days of Christopher Robin. Back to the ways of Christopher Robin. Back to the days of Pooh."
But also, my brother, Randy. He's the one we don't normally talk about. His beautiful wife, Bonnie. And a guy that's just been so much in my heart for so many years, my incredible nephew, Ryan. Did I miss anybody besides my wonderful dad, who is no longer with us, but I know he's watching? Everybody, Mom? She's waving. It's a tough one. I want to also take a, because we're not going to do a long set here at the end, because I don't want to keep everybody too late, because I want you to go home and go, "I want to see that guy again. Tomorrow." Which reminds me, you can buy my CDs at the back, they're for sale, and it's a lot cheaper than having to take me home and feed me until you want me to sing again. Also, when you leave tonight, stop by the silent auction. If you've got the highest bid, apparently, I'm supposed to tell you this, you can pay for it and take it right then. They'll help you out that way. So, and I thank you so much, a few wonderful people, for being here to help me to get this wheelchair that I need, which we're not sure what it's going to cost. The price started at $68,000 and is up to $23,000. And nobody gives me anything to help with that. There's no government agency or anybody that will help. And so I don't think it's going to cost me 23, at least I'm praying that it doesn't. I ask God to please keep that happening the way it is. But I want you to know that this is just it's an incredible time of life for me. I have a new life. A new life with lymphedema in it every day. But I've still got all the same wonderful, amazing friends that I've had, and I've made so many more. I see Pierre sitting there. Good buddy. I've made some incredible friends along the way. Sammy at the back. Everybody sees you, Sammy. I have just made such incredible things happen in my life. I wake up every day and there's a certain amount of pain that I go through all the time. But I'm happy about it. I can still laugh and joke. I can still see the humorous side of life. My faith with God is very strong. And that keeps me. And I'm not preaching to you, but there's a quotation in the Bible that I love very much, and it is 1 Peter 3:15. Always be prepared to defend the hope that is within you, but do it with gentleness and respect. And I live by that. I will not preach, thump, hit anybody with a Bible, but I'm not going to turn God away or deny him because he has been my salvation. I hope that you can accept that. If you're not Christian, I hope someday you will find what you need in your life. I found what I need in mine. And it gives me a great feeling. And I'm going to do a song right now that I... Turn that off. It's going to go crazy. It's a song that was done in 1929. It's an old blues tune. By a guy I emulate. His name was Thomas Waller. They called him Fats. He was a big man. He was also the first African American to ever have his own radio show. He broke the barrier. And about 30 years ago, they started a Broadway musical called Ain't Misbehavin'. It's an amazing musical, all with Fats Waller music. But I love this song more than anything. No one to walk with all by myself. No one to talk with, my love for you is on a shelf. Ain't misbehavin'. Saving my love for you. I know for certain you are the one I love. Through a flood, you're the one I'm thinking of. A misbehaving, saving my love for you. Like Jack Horner in a color, don't go nowhere. What do I care? Your kisses are worth waiting for. Don't stay late, don't get a go. I'm home about 8, me and my radio. Yes, I ain't misbehaving, saving my love for you. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Show earlier where I described scat to you. Anybody put your hand up if you remember that part of the show? Then scat, damn it! I'm in
Calgary. You guys sound like a bunch of cowboys trying to get off the pole. Black Jack Horner in a corner, don't go nowhere. What do I care? Your kisses are worth the wait for. Stay up late, I do not care to go. I'm about 8 minutes on my radio. Ain't misbehaving, same. I said, ain't misbehaving, same my love. Ain't misbehaving. I've been accused of playing a pretty good guitar.
Twice.
I don't say that to pump myself up, but I was listening the other night to a preacher talk, and he was telling about a guy, a preacher, who was voted, and this is a true story, he was voted the humblest preacher in America, to the point where they took him and gave him a medal. And 2 weeks later, they took it back because he was wearing it to church. That is humble. What I say. So I've done the Gordon Lightfoot part, and I've done the Friar Tuck part. I'm kind of into that Louis Armstrong part. And there's two songs I want to do just to kind of fit into that. One is not Louis Armstrong, though. It was Georgia. Georgia. Well, who? Just an old sweet song keeps Georgia on my mind. Each day, Georgia, hears a song of you, rings sweet and clear, like moonshine through the pines. Another song. Reach out for me. Another's eyes smile tenderly, but through restless dreams I see the road leads back to you. Where memories sweet melodies whisper in my heart. Take me back to Georgia. How did we have to part? Out for me, another's eyes smile tenderly.
bop through restless dreams. I see the road, it leads back to you. In Georgia, Georgia, no peace I find, but just an old sweet song keeps Georgia on my mind. Yes, an old sweet song keeps Georgia on my mind.
Thank you. Don't have a lot of time left. You guys have been so wonderful. I'm going to just mention these people one more time that helped me through. Sean, who helped me tonight. Nathan, who helped me tonight. Vic, who helped me tonight. Howard. Kiona, my sweet little niece. I want to thank Robin and Chelsea, and I don't know who else you had back there, but whoever you had. I want to thank Paul. Paul, who's the pastor at my church, who's a man who is himself an incredibly gifted musician. I want to thank Stacy for doing the video for this. By the way, this will be up on YouTube tomorrow night, this whole concert. And I'm going to give a running commentary and tell who I liked and who I didn't like. just kidding. You're sitting there going, grab the machine before we... Okay. I want to thank the Cardo Theater. This is a beautiful theater. I love this place. And I, yes. And I would love to do another show here. I just think this is so wonderful. I don't know if I'm missing anybody. Who am I missing? And time's up. Do, do, do. Excuse me. There's a way to think about life. This is it. When I'm down and oh my soul so weary, when trouble comes and my heart burden me, then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. But I am on your shoulders, you raise me up to more than I can be, 'cause there is no life, no life without its hunger. Restless heart beats so
But when you come and I am filled with wonder, sometimes I think I glimpse eternity.
Picture me at 18 years of age.
Yesterday.
Thank you.
You're all right.
So you're saying I gained 400 pounds in one day?
No, you're saying.
18 years of age, sitting in my mom and dad's living room in Portage la Prairie, Manitoba. I guess it was my living room too. I lived there as well. So there we were, my mom and I, with an old Grundig tape recorder. Now, the portable tape recorders in those days were actually reel-to-reel tapes. But we had one, bought it in Germany, and it came all the way back to Canada with us. And my mom and I turned it on, and we sat there, and my mom and I sang together. You know, she's been wonderful to me in my singing. She said something to me the other day, and I'm gonna repeat it right now, and I hope she doesn't get mad at me for this. But I said I was having a really bad time, and she said, then why don't you write something? It always makes you feel good. That is support for the artistic side of our life. I love that one. All my bags are packed. I'm ready to go. Standing here outside your door. Already I'm so lonesome, I could cry. But the dawn is breaking, it's early morn. Taxi's waiting, he's blowing his horn. Already I'm so lonesome, I could cry. Remember this, Mom? So kiss me and smile for me. Tell me that you'll wait for me. Hold me like you'll never let me go. I'm leaving on a jet plane. Don't know when I'll be back again. Oh, babe, I hate to go. That was for you, Mom.
Yeah, I'm gonna do one more song.
Who cares?
Sorry, I thought I was standing more to the left. My grandmother, my mom's mom, was where I think our talent came from in our family. And I say our talent because I may play this. My brother plays the bagpipes. Is there no beginning to his talent? He will make me pay for that. Don't worry.
He left.
My grandmother was from Scotland. She actually sang, what I understood from her, that she sang a little bit with the Scots National Choir. But she played harmonica. And it was always kind of interesting. And one of the songs she used to play was this one. And I remember this song from that time. And then it became popular about 20 years later. And then the popularity died out again. But I was hosting a dinner with about 300 scientists from Yakutia. Yakutia was the Soviet Union's Northwest Territories. It was the Arctic of the Soviet Union. And these scientists were all Yakutian. They were all Eskimos, or Inuit people, from that part of the world. And I found out from them that they actually, their schooling was an 8-hour day of school, but the first 4 hours were nothing but music, art, plays, all that kind of stuff. And the last 4 hours were academics. And I thought, what a great way to live. The problem with it was, is we were sitting around having dinner, and all of a sudden one of them would jump up and start to sing. And he would just sing these incredible arias or songs, folk songs. And then he'd sit down and somebody else would get up and do it. And through the whole meal it was like that. And then I was supposed to get up and sing for these people. And it's kind of like, I know a friend of mine was a balloon animal guy, and he was hired to do a party with balloon animals, and they had animal making balloons all over the tables, and everybody else did all the balloons before his show came on, and he thought, what the hell am I doing now? What did I do? So I sat up, I sang this song. And the scientist who was in charge of these people, a man of about 60 at that time, and he was an archaeological scientist of some sort, I don't know for sure. But he walked up to me and he said, through his interpreter, he wants you to know that he loves your singing. And I said, thank you. I want you to know and to tell him I loved his singing too. And he said, thank you. And I said, I'd like to hear him again sometime. Wrong words. We're standing in the hotel lobby in Yellowknife, the Explorer Hotel. He just immediately goes off on some incredible song. And when he's finished, everybody, there was hundreds of people around and they clapped. And I, that was wonderful. And he went, now you. Okay. For the next hour, him and I sang back and forth in the lobby of that hotel. It was the most incredible experience. And it just reminds me of this song. This is the Mingalé boat song. It is a Scottish sea shanty. My band in Yellowknife, The Relics, aptly named. We were sometimes 9, sometimes 10, sometimes 12 members. Beautiful female chorus. They loved this song. We had to do it every show. But I'm going to do it for you right now. But as we go through this, I just want you to know. You have made, and I don't want to say I'm an old man, but I'm, you know, an old man. You've made me very happy being here tonight. I love every one of you very, very much. And if you want proof of that, and I've never met you, come and talk to me. You are incredible. Thank you for being here. Hear hope eyes, let her go by,
and all together.
Fluctuates. This is maybe hard to talk about, but sometimes, depending on how much I pee, I can go up 20, 30 pounds, I can go down 20, 30 pounds. When I went to the hospital last year, and this all came about, I dropped 144 pounds in 2 weeks. It is uncomfortable. And by the way, I pronounce that comfortable, not comfortable. They're both acceptable. But what I want you to know is this. I don't care whether you're fat, you're skinny, you've got a limb missing, you've got scars. I don't care whether, you know, you're, whatever you think you have as a deformity, whatever you think you have that's not normal, that's crap. You're all beautiful. Every one of us. I look in the mirror every morning and the first thing I say is, oh, where did that picture of that great looking guy come from? Oh, it's a mirror. I believe that. I believe that I look good. I believe that I am wonderful. And I believe that every one of you is beautiful. Please do not doubt that you are beautiful. And for that, this is what I'll close with. You are so beautiful to me. You are so beautiful to me. Can't you see? You're everything I prayed for. You're everything I need. You are so beautiful to me. So beautiful to me. You are so beautiful to me. Can't you see? You're everything I prayed for. Oh.
so beautiful to me. I see leaves of trees of green, red roses too. Of green, and I sit there, yeah, clouds are white. Well, the brightness of day and the darkness of night, but I know I say to myself, what a wonderful world. Oh, yeah, the colors of the rainbows are pretty in the sky. See it on the faces of the people passing by. I see friends holding hands. How do you do, yeah? What they're really saying is I love you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They're gonna learn much more than I'll ever know. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world it truly is. Yes, I say to myself, believe this, it's a wonderful world. I love you. Good night.